What's up, everyone? Today I'm going to be driving through some of the most scenic areas of Seattle. I'm starting off here at the Gas Works Park, and we're going to be driving through the Northlake neighborhood, as well as Queen Anne to the Seattle Space Needle, through the top of downtown, and then to Capitol Hill. I'm in a rental car right now. Time right now is about 3:15 p.m. It's Thursday, April 27th, 2023. Temperature is about 64 Fahrenheit, 18 Celsius, and wow, this parking lot does not go all the way around. It's good to know. I gotta turn around again. This Gas Works Park is actually very scenic. It's got a beautiful view of the Seattle skyline. Very tight parking area, if I might add. But there is 4 hours free parking here. We're going to be making a left here. There's a very nice trail here for people to bike on and walk. Gorgeous part of Seattle. This street is known as Northlake Way, and we are pretty much on the north of the waterfront here. This bridge in front of me is the Aurora Bridge. It has a big arch going right over the river, or the waterfront, I should say. I guess I should be in this left lane. The road up ahead is closed to through traffic. Under this Aurora Bridge, there's a troll sculpture, which is quite famous for tourists. This light is taking quite a while. What I've noticed about Seattle is that there's a lot of construction going on. passing right under the Aurora Bridge right now into the Fremont neighborhood. This place is pretty cool. There's a lot of cool restaurants here. There's also a community market which takes up the entire block. Huge grocery store. And here we are at Fremont Avenue. This is where I'll be making a left to get to Queen Anne. Left turn signal is green, but nothing is moving. The Fremont Bridge, I see the traffic signal has a red signal. And the arm is going up. It probably just finished opening up and closing. This building at the top right corner is the PCC Community Market I was telling you about. Quite a bit of cyclists here. Trying to get over to the right here, but it might be a little bit difficult. Familiar with an area. It could take a little bit longer. I feel grateful for the driver who let me in and let me change lanes. This Queen Anne area is full of hills, and even though it's very hilly, it has some of the most beautiful landscapes that you'll ever find in the United States. This is Florentia Street. I need to make a left on Queen Anne Street. As you can see, we're going uphill. nice cherry blossoms there. Also a very popular neighborhood for cycling. I wonder how far these cyclists have gone. Their legs are in good shape. I believe this is Queen Anne now. We're making a left turn. Residential street, 20 miles an hour. And it, as you can see, is very steep here. Very steep. Many people think of San Francisco when it comes to hills, but they don't think of Seattle. This is unbelievable. Sorry for the break in the video, everyone. My phone overheated, but it should be good now. This car has good brakes, I can tell you that much. Beautiful cherry blossom tree. It's hard to tell over the crest of these hills sometimes. It gets very tricky. Now this is the commercial area of Queen Anne. is an all-way stop. In angle parking here. Wonder if this child is hot in that suit or not. Looks like a costume. We are going downhill. Before we do though, I want to make a right over here on Highland Drive, because that'll lead us to Kerry Park. Cherry blossoms. Kerry Park is over here to my left. Gorgeous views of the Seattle Space Needle, which we're about to go down to as well. Just going to turn into here and turn around. Maybe we can get a glimpse of that Space Needle from here. I'm not sure if we're going to be able to do so, but if it do, it's on the right hand side. No, it's just right out of frame, unfortunately. But I did come by here and I took a video. definitely a tourist place to visit. These cherry blossom trees are in full bloom right now. Very magnificent sight to see. And now we have a drop, a very, very steep drop. Don't really want to drive too quickly down this hill. Wow, this bus is really going down. My ears pop too. Really testing the brakes here. So the next block after this is Mercer Street, where I'll be making a left. And I'll pretty much take this right into the vicinity of Capitol Hill. There's still a few more turns I need to do before getting there. We are in the vicinity of the Seattle Center. Seattle Center is to the right. I will be making a right on 5th Avenue. That should take us on the eastern boundary of the Seattle Center. Seattle Center, the Space Needle, was built for the 1962 World's Fair, and currently it's an observation tower. You can go up to the top, and there's also a rotating restaurant. Seattle Opera House to the right. No, turn on red. And this guy still goes. I don't know what he's doing, but the rules don't apply to him, I guess. Space Needle's right there. You can see it. Unfortunately, partially obstructed by trees. Let me see if I could tilt the camera up for you all. There we go. Downtown Seattle is to my left. This right here are the tracks for the Seattle monorail. It currently costs $3.50 to ride, only two stops, the Space Needle and also the Westlake Shopping Mall in downtown. It's actually really quick. It takes 2.5 minutes to get from one station to the other, and the trains run every 10 minutes at the peak hours. So it's really convenient. This is Denny Way. I'll be making a left here. This is also a route to get to Interstate 5, which is the main highway that runs through Seattle, north and south. There is downtown Seattle in front of me. There's all the tall buildings. $5.19 a gallon for gasoline here. When you're in downtown Seattle, the gas prices, they cost a lot more. Westlake Avenue. Busy route for the all the transit. The streetcar runs along Westlake Avenue. What an insane hill. Wonder how steep this hill is. Change my Prius into power mode because I need the extra power to go up the hill there. Or I should say the Prius because it's a rental car. Looks like there's another steep hill coming up. I think that's actually the beginning of the Capitol Hill area. This is interesting. Only bus. Never been here before, so that's why I'm acting all excited. The junction with Interstate 5 is coming up. That driver just cutting all the way to the right there. one thing that Seattle has plenty of is traffic. I was reading that Seattle actually has is the third worst city for traffic behind New York and Los Angeles. We passed by Interstate 5. This is officially the Capitol Hill area. I'm making my way over to Broadway, which is the main street in Capitol Hill. Here's Broadway. quite the busy area. Lots of electric buses run through here. Everyone, I'm going to look for parking now. Hope you enjoy this drive through Seattle, Queen Anne neighborhood, Fremont, downtown, and here, Capitol Hill. Thank you so much for joining. Hit the like button, subscribe, and I will see you next time. Bye, everyone. Take care.